my gosh.
Can you see it, you guys?
Look at saying goodbye.
Oh my gosh. It's peering out.
That's precious. Oh.
The pandas are gone. They've been shipped back to China first class on custom-made FedEx planes, filled to the brim with over 250 pounds of bamboo and delicious panda snacks. This marks the end of a unique agreement between the United States and China, made over 50 years ago. Today, we'll be looking at how this all started and saying farewell to the pandas one last time at Pandapalooza in Washington, D.C. So, let's take a look back in time. At the beginning, in 1972. The Godfather just premiered in theaters, Atari released Pong in arcades, and Richard Nixon was re-elected into office. Then, with Cold War tensions across the world, President Richard Nixon made a historic visit to the People's Republic of China. This was the first in over 25 years with no communication or diplomatic ties between the two countries. And this visit set the standard for harmonious relations that continued throughout the Nixon administration. While the main purpose of this visit was to gain leverage over the prominent Soviet Union, Nixon was also able to secure a very important deal for his fellow Americans. That deal? Two American musk oxen traded for two giant pandas. While I personally think the US got the better half of that deal, this exchange opened the door for improved relations between China and the United States. Thanks to President Richard Nixon, I've been able to enjoy the cute, curious, and at times weird giant pandas for years at the National Zoo here in Washington, D.C. But now, after a year of tensions and weather balloons flown between the two powerhouse countries, China took back their giant pandas forever. Thankfully, I went to the National Zoo for the farewell party, Pandapalooza, and I'm excited to share that trip with all of you. Welcome back to Solo Travel POV, and welcome if it is your first time. This is also my first time narrating a video, so please let me know any feedback on the audio quality or narration. Alright, so we're here at the main entrance to the Smithsonian National Zoo on Connecticut Avenue. Admission is free. All you need to do is reserve a pass online and be sure to arrive 1 hour before the zoo closes. The zoo sign here was painted with bamboo just for Pandapalooza. That is the 9-day celebration we're here at now to say goodbye to the pandas. The weather is really nice today. It's a hot day for the fall, so a lot of people came to the zoo today. And you can see that there are signs about pandas everywhere. Alright, let's take a look at the map like I do in all of my videos. As you can see, from the main entrance here, we'll walk through the Asia Trail to the giant panda house. Of course, there's other animals here at the zoo, but the pandas are by far the main attraction. They really did a great job with the Asia Trail. There's loads of bamboo that surrounds the path here, and I heard they even cut down some of this bamboo for the plane ride when transporting the pandas back to China. Here we are at the panda section now. There's so many people taking pictures and videos. I really thought I wouldn't be able to get through, but everyone was really nice today about getting a picture or their own view of the pandas and then moving out of the way for the next person. I did grow a few inches taller just so I could get this shot for all of you guys at home. And here he is. This is one of the three pandas here. Since this guy is so big, I think it might be the male, Tian Tian. And this guy came to the zoo back at the turn of the century in 2000. I really don't think these pandas realize how popular they are or how big the crowds are today. The entire enclosure and the panda exhibit is huge. There's actually another viewpoint of the pandas too, and we'll be walking down to that shortly. Right next to the pandas, the elephants were out and about, but no one really seemed to care as much as seeing the pandas, so there's not too many people over here. We'll go down to the lower viewing area now. It is also an entrance to the Giant Panda Conservation Center. That's the building inside, and the line was huge for this since all the pandas actually went back inside for a little bit here. Here's a cool little sign. You can see the family tree of pandas here, starting with the parents, Mei Qiong and Tian Tian. Most of the baby pandas born here are eventually sent back to China, but the current cub, Xiao Qiji, has stayed here until 2023. I'm gonna add in a cute clip of that baby panda cub sliding through a rare snowstorm we got in Washington, D.C. as well. Unfortunately, the pandas given as a gift during the Nixon administration aren't shown here, and those pandas passed away during the 1990s. To keep the current pandas, the zoo leases them directly from China for $1 million per year. Each year since 2000, the lease has been continually extended until this year in 2023. That's a total of $23 million for the pandas, and it's amazing that the zoo is able to keep its free admittance despite that high cost. All right, now it's time for my favorite part of the conservation center. This is a really cool building and habitat for the pandas here, and I'll show a picture of First Lady Pat Nixon when this building first opened. We are so lucky to see the pandas up close. It's packed in here, but the workers are keeping the crowd moving so that everyone has a fair chance to get their own panda shot. This is the cub, Xiao Qiji, and he's playing with a ball. Honestly, I thought pandas were a little bit overrated, but this is pretty cool to see in person. Earlier, I did see a worker collecting bamboo from outside, so maybe they brought it in here for the pandas to eat. And this is the female adult panda, Mei Sheng. Mei Sheng has given birth 7 times with 4 surviving cubs. Maybe as a silver lining to all of this, when she goes back to China, she'll be able to reunite with her children. And there's even a little pumpkin here. It's perfect for fall celebrations. It's so funny listening to the crowd oohing and aahing when the pandas leave. I've been to this exhibit a few times, and this is the first time I've seen the pandas so active inside. Maybe they can really sense the big crowd that has all come out today for them. I've never seen them climb up so high. For a species that's labeled as lazy sometimes, pandas can really move around. Washington, D.C. and the zoo will definitely miss their pandas. I wonder if they'll transform this building to have facts about different animals, or maybe bring in some animatronic pandas to have this be an education center. You know, the red panda exhibit is next door, and personally I love red pandas, so I'm hoping the zoo can build a bigger red panda habitat next in these buildings. This is what a panda apparently sounds like. Beautiful music to my ears. I learned that scientists believe the black and white fur the panda has serves a similar purpose to zebra stripes, in that it helps them camouflage in the wild. And this is a cast of a panda jaw. I learned that pandas can bite as hard as tigers. All right, here's my favorite part of the conservation center. They have over 40 cameras to keep track of the pandas and monitor them for safety. The National Zoo also has live streams online for panda and animal watching 24/7. Of course, I had to donate for this wonderful experience, and I hope my dollar helps bring the pandas back one day. Let's go ahead and walk through the gift shop here. Most of the panda merch has been sold out. Prices aren't too bad though. It's $25 for a panda plush. And I kind of regret not getting this t-shirt. It's stylish and was made in honor of the birth of Xiao Qiji in 2020. I'll probably see this shirt for like $100 on eBay in a couple of years. The National Zoo here in Washington, D.C. gets over 2 million visitors per year. And given the popularity of the pandas, that's what most people are here to see. Some people I saw were commenting online about their plans to visit the pandas during upcoming Washington, D.C. trips, and those people are saying that their trips are now ruined. I hope that this video might have a special spot or help people that had their trips ruined. Maybe they can watch this instead and feel better about the panda trip they planned. Since the pandas are an attraction for all ages, the panda merch and accessories here are really off the charts. DC is also known for having some beautiful cherry blossoms every year, and the zoo couldn't pass up on the opportunity to create some panda plus cherry blossom merch. Here's a cool statue. Maybe the zoo will auction this off in the future. There's even some special panda-themed food for the event today. Dippin' Dots had a panda special snack, cookies and cream plus Oreos for $6.50. It was actually pretty tasty. You can't really go wrong with Dippin' Dots. This Sbarro sign is pretty cool. Honestly, if the zoo were to auction off anything, this is what I would want the most. And time to get my favorite souvenir. I try to get one of these every time I visit a new place, the Panda Penny. This is a really cheap souvenir, which is why I normally go for them. And the zoo has a few of these stations scattered around. I saw two by the panda exhibit, and both of the ones that I've seen thus far had different options to choose from. I got one here after pressing my penny, and it's a good commemoration of the trip. We'll do a walk through the neighborhood here, Woodley Park in Washington, D.C. It's still filled with so much panda artwork and panda-themed snacks. Right here is supposedly D.C.'s best burger, and it also has the coolest neon panda sign I've ever seen. In this neighborhood, there's even statues of the pandas outside of the zoo. These statues were part of an art exhibition called Panda Mania, hosted by the D.C. Commission on the Arts and Humanities. Personally, I like this one the best that guards over the entrance to the metro station here. There's so many of these panda statues scattered throughout the city, and I'll add a link with a map of each of the statues in the description. Maybe in the future, I'll make a video tracking down each of these statues. And so, despite the abrupt exit the panda saw aboard their custom FedEx planes, leaving this little DC neighborhood that continues to deeply miss them, there might still be hope. United States President Joe Biden and Chinese President Xi Jinping met recently in California, again building back up a line of communication between the two countries. Apparently, a part of their discussion did include the pandas returning to the United States, but this time to the San Diego Zoo.
Please welcome Tian Tian.
And so, while panda diplomacy may be back on the menu, the beloved DC pandas may have to wait just a bit longer before returning to DC and filling that empty hole left in the hearts of many zoo goers and DC natives. Thank you all for watching, liking, and subscribing to Solo Travel POV. This was a new video format, and we're excited to continue creating travel-oriented content while providing new perspective on the histories and oddities of each locations we visit. Expect more videos from Washington, DC, the United States, Greece, and even the grand country of Mongolia coming very, very soon.